that the changes in the workplace are making HR professionals and their employers live in interesting times.
Are Are you under the influence right now?
Are you kidding me? No, I'm not under the influence. Hey, you want some popcorn? Peanuts? You know, anything like that? I've got some stuff in here. Where is it? Is it in here? Brownies? No, maybe not. No, no. I'm under the influence. You gotta prove it.
I don't know if you can do your job at this point. You seem really spaced out.
Well, if you're spaced out, you gotta check out IT once in a while.
I think your reaction has even seemed kind of slowed down to me a lot.
You want to see slow reactions? You see my tennis partner on Sunday for slow reactions. Wow. But the problem is that, you know, everybody reacts differently. You know, I could be under the influence, I could not. I could be paranoid, I could have the munchies, I could be happy, I could be sad. But you got to prove it, because I have money to have it in my system now.
I don't know. I'm going to have to look into this issue, but for right now, just don't smoke it.
Oh, I never smoke it in here. You know, this is really, really stressed me out. I think I'm going to go outside. Let me put my hat on here. I think I need a break. Take my lunch. And, don't worry. I will never smoke it inside the workplace. You don't have to worry about that at all. I'll be out in my car if you need me.
Hey, Fred. I asked you to come in today because I need to talk to you about your recent employment evaluations you've done for your people.
What's the problem?
Well, it's the way you informed your folks of their evaluations.
I brought them with me. What's up? You told me, though, that we were supposed to send them out electronically.
Facebook?
I thought it would be a good idea to surprise the boys by letting the world know about how well the employees are doing. It's an awful lot of discussion, I know, but you know, our people were pleased and their families and friends to see how well they're doing.
Fred, not all your evaluations were positive.
Well, I went to that Butzel seminar you sent me last year. This is a good one, too, but I went there, and, you know, they said you have to be honest and forthright in writing the evaluations, and you got to do that just in case there's ever a lawsuit or something like that.
I'm sure they said that, but I highly doubt that our lawyers would have approved of putting reviews up on Facebook. And I certainly don't think they would have approved this for a project engineer. I printed this off. With Bill working here, there is a village idiot. Facebook, Mark's team would follow him anywhere, but mostly out of a morbid curiosity.
Well, that may have been a little tough, but you know, his team seems to agree with that comment.
What about this one? Phil's productivity sucks. His attendance sucks. His attitude sucks. His golf game sucks. His college fucking sucks. His power sucks. About our bookkeeper. Sheila is so useless around the office, her nickname is Deadwood.
That's what they call her.
And finally, I think this might be the best. Did you have to say this about the head of our accounting department? Tina is so incompetent that she couldn't count her fingers twice and come up with the same answer.
I gotta tell you, she seems to be making less mistakes yet when we put that.
Understand that Facebook is basically public. Almost anyone can see this. I want you to stop using Facebook. distribute the evaluations confidentially if you have to use email, send it to, just to the person who's being evaluated. Okay, now I want to talk to you about that open branch manager position. You proposed promoting Dan. I think that's a mistake.
Dan's a good man.
That may be, but John has a MBA from Michigan, and he's much more experienced. Dan only has an associate's degree.
John's a goater.
A goater? What are you talking about?
Well, I was looking online, and I saw an article about a guy raising goats in his backyard in Ferndale.
So?
It was John's uncle.
I'm still not getting the picture here.
Well, I did some work checking. It turns out that John's father owns a manufacturing plant in Warren, but he's not originally from Michigan.
You can't discriminate against somebody for their national origin.
I know that, but it's not where he's from that's the point. He's from Montana. It's what John's dad did when he lived in Montana.
I'm afraid to ask, what did he do in Montana?
He was a goater. In fact, his whole family has herded goats. For 10 generations, they've done nothing but herd goats.
So what? John does not herd goats?
It's in his blood, and genes don't lie.
You can't be serious. You can't discriminate against somebody because of their genetic background. Just like I can't discriminate against you because you're mentally ill. Anyway, herding animals isn't a genetic trait. I can't believe I'm hearing this conversation.
Mark my words. Someday you'll find goats out in the front lawn in their lawn in a Bloomfield office, and John will be out there trying to milk one. And if it's not that, I'm sure he's going to quit and move to Montana to raise goats.
Are you feeling okay?
Goats don't play well in Bloomfield Hills.
I'm worried about finding you out on the lawn grazing. You're crazy. Promote John.
Whatever.
Hello? Ben?
Yes?
You there?
Hey, Scott, it's Ben. You got a second?
Yeah. Hey, are you with your cell phone? Ben. Ben.
Yeah, I'm on the way to the airport, but I need those figures for the XYZ deal that we talked about. I need them for that 1 o'clock conference call.
Hey, are you on your cell phone? Because we've got a really crappy connection.
Yeah, but I'm hands-free. Well, hands-free on the phone. Rest assured, both of my hands are on the wheel.
You know you're not supposed to be talking on your cell phone in the car. Did you get that new policy we put out last month?
I read it, but, man, work needs to get done. I thought it was just one of those HR CYA policies that you don't even have to follow. Anyway, this is a huge deal, and I have to have those figures. I need to know the projected payroll for the merged companies. Do you have that yet?
Yeah, actually, I just finished working on that this morning. Let me pull it up. Okay, I'm ready. Shoot.
All right, just a second. Let me finish sending this email. Okay, done. All right, got some paper in here somewhere. Okay.
What?
All right, shoot.
Okay. The salary payroll is projected to be $2,375,000. Ben, what was that? What was that? Are you okay? Ben!
Can you find me the codes? Do you think you could dial me in?